Let's see what this. All right, I think I'm good. All right. Baton Rouge, don't you dare be sour. Clap for the owner of ICW and feel the power.
Red sky gleaming from my eyes, tides rising up to new heights.
Yeah, what's going on, Sama gang? It's your boy Llama Sama that be bringing the drama, you know what I'm saying? Final episode of Monday Night Turmoil, and we are here live in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. We got another stop, we got an Insanity, and then we heading straight for the Superdome in New Orleans, Louisiana. I'm excited, I'm ready, and we got a lot to unpack. We got a lot to unpack. So Final Destination, literally a couple days away, literally on Saturday is going to be the first night. It will be hosted on 2K23, and we'll have a lot of jam-packed matches. And the other side will be hosted on Sunday on 2K24. And you will be seeing a lot of great updates, a lot of great matches, including the first ever ICW ambulance match between me and Jester. For the first time ever, me and Jester go up against each other at Final Destination, and it is about to be the first ever ambulance match. So I'm excited, and I hope you guys are excited as well. We got a lot of other matches as well. We got the Turmoil Women's Championship, Luna and Alexi, the Women's Championship being defended in the Fatal 4-Way for Insanity. Eric taking on Grimm, Phantom taking on Alpha. Got a lot of other jam-packed championship matches. And we also have a championship match for you all tonight as well, as Kit Kat has redeemed his rematch clause, and it'll be him versus Bully God for the Eternal Dragon Championship. So whoever wins that match is going to be replaced in that triple threat between the Eternal Dragon Champion, the Himothy Champion, Architect, and the Haas Champion, Barbarian. Now, without further ado, let's go ahead and get right to the show, because we have these matches, and we also do have a backstage interview with David the Joker before his match for the Global Worldwide Championship against his best friend, WTI. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get right into it. Starting off the first match of the night, La Plata of House Music, one half of the Turmoil Women's Duos Champions, take on Britt the Brat, as these two teams will go up against each other at night one this Saturday. Also, one more thing, you guys, I do have an issue with YouTube, so I don't have premium right now at the moment, so I might do like a playlist of like not copyrighted music for right now until I get that back. So, my fault, y'all. I apologize. So, let's just try to keep it, like, try to keep it going as good as we can. So, let's get into it.
The following is scheduled for 1-4, making her way to the ring, accompanied by Princess Sinister. From Gomez Palacio, Durango, Mexico, one half of the Triple Crown Women's Tag Team Champions, Mad Dog Sinister Silva.
What's up? Tough. Streaming currently. It was a fun game. Plata versus Britt the Brat, 15 minutes on the clock, and this matchup begins. And now Britt starting off strong in control here, hits a Michinoku driver. Now Britt with a brain buster. Delivering the shoulder right into the gut. It is. Power slam. Try to go for an elbow drop, but Plata able to counter. Hits a enziguri to the side of the chin. Wrestling takedown. Playing possum, going for the pin. Kick out at one. Spine buster. And clothesline in the corner by Britt. Countered. Now Britt able to counter yet again. Plata with another counter. Delivering the kicks. Mm-hmm. Ooh, deep six. Well, and a kick out or two. Try to go for a move, it was countered. And now Plata, gut buster. And she's got that sleeper locked in. And Britt able to break free out of the hole, delivering the knees right to the head. Ooh, and a spear. That might have put Plata to rest. One, two, and a kick out at two. Now Plata rolls out to the outside. Now Britt giving chase. Counts at six right now. Counts at seven. Plata is just chilling on the barricade, trying to gain her breath. And now she's able to run back inside the ring. Patrick Snape, thank you for the follow. I appreciate it. Welcome to the Sama Gang. How you doing, man? Hope you're having a good one. And Dobby, thank you for the first. I appreciate you. How you doing, gang? Try to go for elbow drop, but Plata able to roll out of the way. Wait. Amon? My boy Amon Darkness. Amon, that's not you, bruh. Amon, that's not you, bruh. I am okay. Oh, my fault. I was about to say, I thought you was somebody else. I was about to be like, hold on, they ain't a mine. I'm glad you're good, bro. I'm glad you're good. Hope you're having a good one. How'd you come across me, if you don't mind? And another dragon sleeper locked in. But Britt, once again, able to break free out of that hole. I remember this song. This was, Toonsy's old outro. But nah, I knew this basically all Toonsy's. You searched me? Hey, yo, that's dope. I appreciate it, man. Thank you for coming by, showing love, bro. Means a whole lot. Oh, try to go for the kick in the corner, but Britt able to find a way to counter. And now Britt. Ooh. Beautiful back suplex. And now a head crank. Goes on a rampage backstage, flipping tables, lighting the tables on fire, and super kicking everyone near him. See, I just kick Stan. Stop being controversial. Gotta calm down, man. And now Plata going up the top rope. She had nothing planned. I guess she just wanted to go up the top rope. But she did get countered, though, by Britt. Now Britt going up top rope herself. Oh, backbreaker. Don't tell me to calm down. Right, that was a funny, segment. I will never forget that. It's even funnier that Sean Spears was in that segment too. Counter. And a suplex. Shoulder tackle. And now going up the top rope. Try going for a submission, it was countered. Go for the pin. Kick out at two. Plata able to pick up the win with a submission over Britt. Confidence all around the women's duos champions. They're extremely confident that they can take down J Money and Britt at Final Destination. To the next matchup, Stars, Palisinki and Star Move take on Heavy Artillery, Primary and Quinn Zell.
Do it.
Backstream was buffering. Wait, am I buffering for real? Quintel might be a different person coming out of my eyes. It was me. Oh, all right. Quintel might be a different person coming out of my eyes. Why you say that? Wait, is the person in your story mode, Quintel? She's going through is wild, man. Yeah, I said you finish mine. She already going through it. I still haven't won a belt. I know that feeling. Got camouflage. I think that might be like the top she's wearing. Yeah, I think so. I think in the other game, that's what she's wearing too, I think. For 5 seconds. Nah, I'm gonna be very real with you. I'm like looking at this matchup, but at the same time, it's like when you get off, you get those get off work type things, and your eyes just start moving on its own rotation. That's what I'm going through right now. But I'm looking. This is going on. Stars pick up the win against Heavy Artillery. The tag team division is definitely about to be a handful next season, and I cannot wait to see what everybody in ICW Season 6 will become. Eric the Great goes one-on-one against undisputed ICW Tag Team Champion and one-half of the Insanity, or one-fourth of the Insanity World Tag Team Champions, former Turmoil World Champion, first ever Insanity World Heavyweight Champion, Mr. JTG Jolt the Goat. Yeah, I'm gonna be off headphones for a minute, but if y'all have a question, just text me in chat. I got y'all. Alright, Eric the Great, Jolt the Goat, one-on-one. This matchup begins. Thank you. You're welcome. Hey, yo, Eric, appreciate the light, big dog. I appreciate it. They're in the shoulder tackle back and forth, attacking the arm now. Drop kick by Joe. Back suplex. Slam. Delivering the mean blows in the corner. Clothesline in the end it. Oh, lie detector. Fear. Eric picks up the win. But here comes the Turmoil World Champion. These two face each other one last time before Final Destination 3. Sound like you're under the influence. Cole, I'm nowhere even close. Alright, well, I hope Eric stays and represents his homies as the Meat Foundation, Yeti, and Professor Skeet Meat, aka Dewan, will take on Poison Styles, Yodoku Sasori, and Bruce Jackson in tag team action. I wish I was, though. I definitely wish I was. Mighty won't. Can Eric pull it off on Sunday? Low energy, maybe? Yeah, probably what it is. Yeah, I just work really not that long ago, so. It's kind of lingering, and it's there, but I think I'll be fine. I'm trying to make sure that I don't, like, pass out type thing. Like, I ain't gonna lie to y'all, I'm here, I'm physically here, but I'm letting you know, as soon as this mug is over, I'm knocked the fuck out. Hold on, I'll be right back.
I'm
Alright, I'm back, y'all. So I had to run to the bathroom real quick. Yeah, I was in the bathroom trying to get my energy back. Yerko, what's the word? I saw you was in here. Freckles. Auntie Frex, what's the word? What's going on? How you doing? Hope you're having a great day. I did just say you said you was hitting. Bodyguards better take these rookies mean business. Wait, who's fighting for the duo's championship? So is it the Me Foundation? Not W Show. I'm crying. I'm not. I felt that. I should have. Yeah, I was gonna say I was gonna be back, but I ain't really like per se where I was going. But yeah, I'm here. Mr. Lishin on the mission. That's a fire rhyme scheme. Oh, Mr. Lishin on the mission. Hey, yo, we finna. Go, Lishin, they gonna start calling you that now. W bars, oh God, W bars. Me Foundation and Bodyguards for the Turmoil Duels Championship. I bet. Well, that's another match for night one. Celeste going one-on-one against, I already forgot, Shuby of ESF. Celeste will defend the, that's by me, nobody better not steal it. They gotta copyright your stuff, Freckles. Celeste will challenge Dara Barbera for the, it will not be the Undisputed Women's Championship in Season 2, in Season 6. It'll be something else completely different. I'm too poor. I'm weak. I feel that. Guys, I'm low-key excited, but at the same time, I'm low-key just, like, not. Because I'm happy at the fact that I get an off day tomorrow. But I know for a fact that I'm not going to be able to rest in like I usually do. ESF hasn't been the same since leaving me. Yeah, some of them won championships. Some of them lost championships. I mean, Themis is still a champion, but she has to defend her RTW championship inside a ladder match. Right. Celeste versus Shuby, one on one, 15 minutes on the clock, and this matchup begins. The ICW Undisputed Women's Champion. I know her and Dara are gonna probably have a classic for real, because this is Dara's actual like first title match. Singles title match. Ooh. Oh, these Uranagis by Celeste. Elbow drop. Kick out at one by Shuby. Deck breaker. Hurting the arm. Throwing some punches right there to the face. Delivering them once again. Celeste able to counter. And now Celeste with the guillotine locked in. And now able to break free. Ooh. And then a kick right to the side of the face. A little some damage there to the arm. Ooh. Then the kick. And an exploder suplex out of the corner. Now going for the pin. One, two. And the kick out at two. And try to use the knee, it was blocked. And a super kick right to the face. Ooh, locking up the arms into a German suplex. Oh my god. Combination. Ooh. Going for the pin. Kick out at one. And go for the pin. Kick out at one. God, bro. I gotta stop feeling tired. Members of ESF are well trained in combat, if anything. They try their best in the ring, though. That's all that really matters. Another Uranagi by Celeste. Goes to show you why she's the undisputed women's champion right now. Kick out at one. Oh, also, for those that don't know, if you guys do know, so if you guys probably have heard, that move never works. Possum pins rarely work from time to time. Dang, go, you made me forget what I was about to say. Yeah, okay, I remember. So if y'all know about the Global Worldwide Championship, so night one of Final Destination, whoever wins between Dobby or David, that person will become, if they're on since the championship's on Turmoil, it will be known as the Intercontinental or International Championship, due to Jester taking the Intercontinental Championship, because we're going to separate the Global Worldwide title from, separate the titles back again, so... Turmoil has the Intercontinental or International Championship, and I once again have the United States Championship on my show. So, night two of Final Destination on 2K24 will be a six-man gauntlet match for the United States Championship. And I want you guys' opinions. Who y'all think should be in the gauntlet match for the United States title? Cole, let's just talk about some not it. You didn't even make yourself yet. I can't put you in. Yeah, it has to be on 2K24 only. And I know we have the list of people that we've made. Not it. I'm weak. Wait, you actually saying you made yourself? I don't even think Noob has the game yet either. And I would have signed him up definitely if he would have gotten it. I'm lacking a moveset at the moment. Also, you do have the game. And from the guillotine, Celeste was able to make Shuvi chat out. So is everyone else. True. Oh, so you're talking about all the ESF and then all the other people that you made are all lacking movesets. I feel like it takes some time for real, so you gotta do what you gotta do, man. You gotta do what you gotta do. But I don't know who I'm going to vote yet, so I'm going to probably think about it. Also, during night two of Final Destination, I have also put, except for ESF, haven't made them yet. It also does take some time to make them too, because you have to get another lab and start creating everything back from scratch for this new program, I would say. All right, next match, Soul of Lilith 420 versus Heather Ray one-on-one. What I was about to say, another match has been confirmed for night two of Final Destination. Yodoku Sasori will defend the Cruiserweight Championship because that will still be a championship for ICW. Who he's defending the title against? Well, I have handpicked a great opponent for Mr. Yodoku, as he will challenge Mr. Eric the Don. It's going to be a Cruiserweight showdown, and I cannot wait to witness such great classics on night two of Final Destination, especially night one too, because I already know you guys are going to have a huge, huge drop of bangers for night one. Male Star of the Year for Turmoil got to be the now of ICW, as much as we mess with him. You know what? I give you the respects. That is true. That is true. He definitely has done a lot around season 5 and going on up till. So if we got to give the Male Star Turmoil a great award, especially for all the stuff that people, all the stuff that people's been putting down, especially for this year or last year. Yeah, I'd definitely pick Kendrick Ali. Gotta give it to Noob. Yeah, he has suffered so much, but he's definitely deserving of that award. Who you pick for female star though, Jester? And if we thinking the same thing, he hasn't suffered enough. He hasn't suffered enough. It's crazy. That man went to the rookie development and y'all tortured the hell out of him. I think he suffered enough. I think I know who Jester's going to say, but I'm waiting for him because I know for a fact who it is. That was not who I was expecting. I'm guessing you're talking about Bri Bri, but that is hilarious. That was not who I was expecting. Female Star of the Year for Turmoil. Yeah, that. You know what? All right. These are some unusual answers. But Justice has picked and he's voted for them. So Male Superstar of the Year for Turmoil goes to Kendrick Ali. Female Star Turmoil goes to Bri Bri. Alright, that's some accomplishments right there. They definitely have a list of accomplishments. Now, match of the year though. Turmoil's match of the year. Who are you giving it to? We've had a lot of matches for a while. Who do you think I was picking? To be honest with you, in my head, I thought you were gonna pick Freckles. I'll be straight up honest with you. I literally thought you were just gonna pick Freckles off of it. I tried to be non-biased. Understandable. Thank you. And I definitely have to pick my stars for male star and female star of insanity. Wait a minute. Let me think about this real quick. Let me see something. She was second choice, but gotta respect the pure guts of Brie. True, she definitely did make an epic comeback season, or this season. Winning multiple tag titles and then coming through, winning the RCW championship and held that motherfucker for a good minute. Had classic match after classic match. It was unreal. Wait, let me think of something real quick. I'm trying to figure it out. Because if I'm now seeing this right now, I thought I never missed an episode of Monday Night Turmoil, but then I realized I missed Juneteenth because Jester wanted to call that off. That's funny. But yeah, all right, Jester. I just realized I never missed an episode of Turmoil at all, unless it was during around the holidays. I've never missed an episode. Damn this dedication, bro. I probably can't say the same for Eternity, though. But then again, that's probably the same way, too, but... That is insane, bro. Going for the pin. Kick out of two. Thank you. Oh, you say you back, Justin? I didn't even know. I was like, I was thinking about it, and I was like, I don't think I missed an episode or like missed a week of like Monday Night Turmoil and Insanity. I think if it was a holiday, then yeah, but I don't think we've ever missed one. Yeah, what's up, Devin?
Yo.
What's going on?
Not much.
You good?
Nah, I'm fine. I just won like two back-to-back games on Blood Hunt.
Oh, nice.
Fucking got 14 kills on the first game and 26 kills on the second game. Don't you fucking dare say it.
I was holding it in, I ain't say it, I'm holding it in, but don't get offended when somebody in the chat calls you it now.
No, because they can't call it to me either. I don't give a fuck.
You sure about that?
I don't give a fuck, they're not allowed.
Uh-huh. Well, actually, since you here, we want to know about your predictions.
I don't know. Last time I gave my predictions, y'all didn't like them. I think I'm going to keep it to myself.
Oh, what? That you cursed all the shit of us? Oh, yeah. Me Foundation did be poison style.
I was watching. And I was watching with Yeti and him.
Yeah, so now they have an opportunity against the bodyguards for the duo
also,
championship.
Also, you forgot to put their belts on them.
Oh, yeah, I did forget. My fault. I got it. Look, it's been a long day. I was already, like, tired when
I
started.
Hey, listen, it's been a long day for me, too. I thought I was supposed to be getting my rental car today, but it looks like I'm going to have to do that tomorrow, so.
My rental car? Where you going?
Nowhere. I'm finally getting my car fixed.
Oh, I'm about to say, we in your home state. The fuck you think you were going? We got all these shows in these states. We in Baton Rouge right now. How you feel?
Well, I mean, I got like one member out there.
That's crazy. Or should I say Dobby Chan?
Jester. Fuck you.
Should we ask about this? Is there something you're not telling us?
Fuck you, Jester.
What do you do?
The fucking Dobby Chan.
What is Dobby Chan? What we doing here?
Dobby Chan is me in a fucking maid outfit. That's what that is.
Oh. What, they brought it back?
No, God, no. Thank God. I'm gonna have to raise the points on that one just a little
bit. You should have said Dobby Moon, Jester.
Fuck you. Actively fuck you. I hope you drop a bowl of cereal at your house.
That's crazy. I already did. Congratulations. Anyway.
Alright, I hope you do it again.
Alright. Look. So, I want to know about your predictions for night one of Final Destination, since you're going to be hosting night that one.
Night.
Night one is Saturday. So, I'm going to list off a couple matches, and I want your predictions on them. Who you think's gonna win? Who you think's not gonna win?
All right, hit me.
You know what? I'm gonna just say who you think's gonna win. We're not gonna say who not. So, gonna be nice to everybody.
Yeah.
All right, hold on. Let me put down one more. Oh, speaking of which, I also do have one more thing to put in mind for y'all. Tyrone's retirement match will be at Final Destination. Since he's not coming back to season 6. It's still sad, bro. It's still sad to see this man go. I don't know who his opponent gonna be either. We'll have to figure out who his opponent gonna be. Probably gonna be Chaos, because you know, you gotta put the respects for two goats. But alright, Dobby, you ready? Dobby,
what's up?
You ready?
Yeah.
All right. First one. We got Shade and Jaden Wolfie for the television championship.
Oh, I want to give it to Jaden as much as possible, but I gotta give it to Shade. I'm giving that one to Shade. I've seen this man for 2 years straight, and he I think he's like me. I don't think he's lost that final destination. I could be wrong, but
once
he's
1-1. He lost to Chai.
Okay. Well, yeah. I think he can redeem himself this year. Now it'd be nice if Jaden did win at his first WrestleMania at Final Destination. So. I'm giving that one to Shade.
JSM versus Spirit for the Universal Championship.
Oh! No comment.
No comment at all.
No comment.
Dang.
No comment.
Understandable. All right. The RTW Championship ladder match between Themis, Ray of Sunshine, Primary, Non, Misty, and Nova.
You know what? I'm giving it to Coalition's people. Themis.
Themis is going to retain.
I'm giving that to Themis.
All right. Dobby versus David the Joker for the Global Worldwide Championship.
Oh, that's crazy. It's almost like me. Duh.
Oh, you going to pick yourself?
Yeah, that's crazy.
Well, that's crazy because we're going to be interviewing David the Joker backstage later on, so I hope you're going to be there too.
I could be there. We'll see.
All right. Luna versus Lexi for the Turmoil Women's Championship. Main event.
Wait, Luna?
Luna. As in Luna Otosoko.
Otosoki. Oh, fuck. I'm going with my baby. Yeah. Oh, y'all brought that rivalry up three times.
Look, first off, it would have been Luna and Freckles, but Lexi wanted it more. And this is going to be both of their first main events in Final Destination. So
I want them both to win, and I know I can't, so... But I'm going to choose my baby. I'm going to choose my wifey. I'm choosing Lexi.
So now we're
going to
now do some matches from night two. This is going to be on 2K24, so you already know that this is about to be more jam-packed than you think it is.
No, I heard that.
We have the six-man gauntlet match for the United States Championship. Now, we don't have anybody selected yet, but if you had to pick somebody to be a part of that matchup, who do you think?
Man, I'm doing Mr. Ladder Man himself, Mr. Archangel. I'm giving to
very funny
architect,
but he's gonna be in a match as well between Barbarian and who else was it? Either Kit Kat or Bully God.
United States match. You said six men.
It's a six-man gauntlet match. Which means somebody's gonna have to start the gauntlet off and has to stay in that mode for as long as they can.
Turmoil or Insanity, if you don't mind me asking.
It could be either show, but I might have it be Insanity because Justin's gonna have the Intercontinental Championship.
Damo?
Okay.
Damo. My boy Damo.
That's a good selection.
Damo Savage. Damo Bam.
We'll see. All right.
United States of Damo.
All right. Sama versus Jessa Designs in the first ever ICW ambulance match.
Oh, no comment.
No comment as well.
No comment.
I feel that. It probably might be Jessa. But Nico versus Samantha Garrett versus Cater versus Del Tiva for the Sandy Women's Championship Fatal 4-Way.
Nico.
Nico to retain.
Nico. Give it to my girl, Nico.
All right. Alpha Aztec versus Phantom for the Insanity World Championship.
I'm giving it to my little brother. He's grinded. He's fought me. He's fought you. He's fought Jester. He's fought Architect Spirit and so many others, and he's failed so many times. But he is the underdog, and I want the underdog to finally win. I'm calling it out.
You think it's going to be his night? It's going
to
be his moment?
I think it's going to be his night. It's time for him to shine. It's time for him to... He need to step out from the shadow between... He has to step out of the shadows of under us. He, like, I'm Ace. You Sabo. Luffy gotta go start doing his own thing. It's time for Luffy to start doing his own thing.
The main event of night two, Eric the Great versus Grimmer Fade for the Turmoil World Championship.
No comment.
No comment on that as well.
No Dang, comment. Man.
You ain't commenting on
no the comment.
Lot, Kit-Kat realizes he can't win by countout, right? I think he does, but you know, you get a lot of CTE when you're wrestling these days. All right. Also, one more thing. Will you be available for the draft?
Me or?
Yes. Like, I'm trying to see if you, Cole, and Jester. I'm trying to find a day for all of us to do the draft. It's going to be
after. As long as it's on a weekend, I will be fine.
I say it's going to be literally either the last week of March or it's going to be the first week of April. The draft
Which
is coming
reminds
up
me,
soon.
I'm going to have to host Friday night fights on Thursday because I have an eventful day on Friday.
Understandable. But so far, we do have almost everybody made and everybody's overalls have all finally came together. I bet you cannot guess who's the highest overall character. Right
guess
now,
who the I can't guess. Hmm. You know what? I'm gonna go ahead.
I'm gonna give you three guesses.
Okay.
You say you're gonna exclude me.
I'm gonna exclude you and Jester because I know y'all ain't that like high and mighty. Y'all
you would be correct because we're not the highest at this moment, but I will say we're pretty up there. Let me know. All right, Jester, I got you.
I'm fairly certain.
I tried to give myself an 85, but people were like, just shut the fuck up and do yourself justice. And I was like, all right, man. So I just gave myself a
95. I was about to say, give me an 85. And then y'all were like, nah, you have like a 94. I'm like, okay, well, fuck.
That's crazy that you guessed your overall spot on. Yeah, it's a 94. Other than me. Jester, you are you're a 97. Yeah, you're like tied with somebody. So Jester is.
I don't know.
He's one of the highest, but there's another person that is higher than he is. Actually, they're both tied for 97, so they're both of the highest. Overall.
Are they on are they on Turmoil or Insanity?
They're currently on Insanity.
All right, so we need to get rid of the entire Turmoil cast. Okay.
I got a feeling. Currently on Insanity? Me the fuck. Currently on Insanity, but goes to Turmoil.
But goes to Turmoil? All
yes.
Right. Let me see something. Male superstar or female superstar?
Female superstar.
Female? All right. Now we're cutting shit down.
And Kit Kat is once again Eternal Dragon champion, 2-time champion, and he will join the battle between Architect Barbarian for the Sky's the Limit Championship at Final Destination, and it will be on night two, actually.
I'm gonna say Luna.
Freckles is incorrect, but Luna is the correct answer. Luna is a 97. Freckles is a 95 this season, or next season. And Coalition, you even make yourself, so I don't know what to exactly give you. But we'll figure something out.
Let's go.
Yeah, it was Luna.
Oh my god, I can't believe I guessed that. That was a guess. If you guys want to ask
about anybody else's overalls, I have all the information right here. Oh, Coalition, you is a 91. I forgot. Like, I got Phantoms now. I have all the other SG members. I have Spirits. I bet y'all can't guess who's the lowest overall.
Shout out to Jay Briscoe
with the new bro.
Lowest overall?
Lowest overall.
Insanity or Turmoil?
Insanity.
so Insanity again. Male or female?
Female. Well, tied. Okay, female again. They're both on Insanity, and it's a male and female. And they're both
it's
tied.
A male and a female?
Royal. Yes.
Okay, so it's double guess. Male and female.
Jesta got it right. Jesta got the female right. It's Diamond.
Thank God. Okay.
Diamond is a 76. Well, they're not. Well, then they're
Diamond's,
not tied.
Oh, they're half then.
No, they're not tied then. Ian is an 89.
Ian? Okay.
I made him I made him 89 because, you know, he's the first wrestler to ever wear a singlet, so I'm going to need to give my singlet people some respect. But it is a male superstar. He is on Insanity currently, and it's somebody that you would least expect. Especially for someone his size. No, not J-Tur.
Someone his size. Wait a minute, they're big. Is it Blank Face?
No. Blank is, if I remember, if he's on here. That's crazy. I forgot to write Blank. But Blank is an 88.
I don't know.
The correct answer is Barbarian.
Wait, what about Jordan Armstrong? Oh, damn, okay.
Barbarian is a 79 this year.
Wow.
He was an 84. But I don't think that's going to stop him regarding to his size anyway, so. Barbarian? Yep, Barbarian, man.
Yeah.
And then, you know, we got to show love to the new people that's coming through for this show as well. You know, we got my boy Big JJ joining the series. He's going to be an 87 for the starting season. Grizz, 86. I'm a god.
Fucking Tekken and I just gotta practice.
Oh, Lexi is a 93 too. So tell her congratulations when you get the chance. I feel like you did not hear that at all.
I'm kind of dying at the moment.
Dying at what? Wait, are you playing something wild in the middle of this?
Yeah.
Understandable. I ain't gonna lie to you, this season we definitely got a lot of 90s. A lot of high 80s too. Now I gotta pick out three other finisher names. Oh yeah, because we get five finishers and five signatures this season. I don't even know what to call my stuff.
I'm getting Hell's Gate as a submission hold though. You don't have whatchamacallit in here anymore, so I'm getting Hell's Gate.
Who?
Hell's Gate. Undertaker's submission hold.
Oh. Wait, because you're saying nobody was using Hell's Gate?
Yeah. I couldn't use it in 22 because you had that guy with the fucking doctor mask having it.
Oh, the plague.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, what's his name? German Invader. I think that's his name, but he's gone now. I had a lot of weird people back in 22. Llama hired Drew to weaken me, Ryle. I mean, I have a match on Wednesday too, so you ain't really alone on that. I'm just trying to prep us up for our ambulance match. When I said I want us to go to our limits, we about to go crazy in that ambulance match. Wait, Coalition, are you still in here?
I think so.
Coalition, if you're still here, I want you to know one thing. That boy Coalition go have a retirement match too. Cause he ain't gonna be wrestling no more. I'm gonna give him one more match to show.
Considering the fact that he's trying to sit here and make sure he's trying to make sure your rookie division ain't doing good.
What do you mean he's trying to make sure my ain't doing good? What are you trying to do? Sabotage it or something?
No, he's just. He wants to win the He wants to win whatchamacallit. He wants to win Battle of the Shows.
He'll be alright. I mean, at least we give him a retirement match. I want to at least give him his flowers before he departs from wrestling forever. Which then again now confuses me. Why am I giving you a 91 overall if you're not gonna be wrestling? Stay down, son. What you mean, Cole? Come on, we need to at least give you a retirement match, bruh. And I know the perfect opponent for him, too. Dobby, you should know where I'm going with this.
I hope it ain't me.
No, what the? You already have a match!
Oh, I don't know. I don't know. Okay, bro, you're not. Let me explain something to you. When you say this, you're not explaining whether or not that's going to be at the night or not.
It is going to be at the night.
All right, David, you didn't say that. So I'm like, okay, I'm assuming this is going to be like one of the first regular shows of Insanity or Turmoil. I don't know that.
Oh, my fault. But yeah, nah, he's going to have a match at the Final Destination. I already know who his opponent's going to be, too. Since they both have a... It's just they both have retirement matches. Nah, I got it. It's going to be both have a retirement match. It's going to be Tyrone.
You're going to make him fight Big Black Tyrone. Coalition versus Big Black Tyrone. Okay, that's where I draw the line. Both, hey,
I don't trust your
booking.
You shouldn't. You're both having retirement.
You're going to make this man fight this fucking darkness.
You're both having retirement matches. You might as well, man. Ain't no better way to end off your career than having to defeat over Tyrone. You want your ass kicked, don't you? I already gonna get my kicked in the ambulance match. And Jester with the win over Drew. Yeah, he is dedicated for his match. You really want your ass kicked? Come on, Cole. It could be a great match. I mean, it's either that or Darth Vader versus Tyrone. Up is the direction you have me fucked. That is crazy. Aye. How about this? Since Dobby did say a good idea, and he did give me a good idea, we can do, we can have you fight one of the members from WCF for your retirement match. Since that is some of the people that you made. Is Jester retired yet? No, but we're both already fighting. If I have to take an L, I take it from him.
I was gonna say, if you was about to make me fight him, I ain't had no problem with that.
Ooh, fight
you
coalition?
Said fuck it. Yeah.
I mean, you already fighting David.
No, I understand. I didn't know that was at the...
Wait, don't do it, Jester. Don't drop out of this. Don't drop out of our match, man.
No. I got a better one. Before what? Jester says what he has to say. How about this? Just hear me out, all three of y'all.
He's pulling double duty. So Jester saying that night one, he can fight Coalition, and that night two, he can fight me.
I was gonna say, instead of doing double duty, y'all have an ambulance match, right?
Right.
Make it a triple threat.
You can't make it a triple threat ambulance match.
I was about to say, make it a triple threat ambulance match.
There's no way. How the fuck you gonna put two niggas in an ambulance?
Like the WWE hasn't figured that out before.
They never done that. At least I don't think they have. Actually, looking at it, it's crazy that as soon as we reach night one, Lexi would have held the Turmoil Women's Championship for 36 days.
That's my baby.
But we still got this record-breaking run for Anubis and Coach of the Bodyguards. They've held the Duels Championship for 124.
Hold on, wait a minute. They about to catch up to our record, me and Spirit's record.
Your record is 160. I don't think they're going to catch up to it. If they win, they might. So you better pray. I'm saying is that nobody beat Bree's record at all.
Nah, Bree had it like for almost. Yeah, was she was the first. She was the first tribal chief.
Yep, 169, bro. Still the longest record champion of all time. There'll never be another record like that for real, unless somebody is just like merely undefeated every single time. But she was on a good run, though. And I don't even know who she lost that championship to. Never mind. I know who it was. I had to think about it. Every day, more and more, it's just more history being made. I already know we got a shit ton of Triple Crown champions. I can't name them all, but we do have some Triple Crown winners. Huh?
I'm playing a game.
Oh. I didn't know you could hook your game up to the commentary desk. These small ass tablets. Gentlemen, welcome to the main event. Or we can have ourselves a little gauntlet. Talking about from the Four Horsemen. I don't think I'm gonna be booted up for a gauntlet match, bro. Especially against all y'all. Don't get me wrong, I'll fold Coalition and Dobby easily, but I'll be tired to fight you after.
I'm sorry, the fuck.
What? I ain't say nothing. All right, y'all. We know that this is the main event of Turmoil, the final episode of this season, too, man. This is insane. We had to look back at it. So many crazy moments have happened on this show, especially on Insanity as well.
I can't get out, like it's the rush. Run. Are you serious?
Like since you here, Dobby, quick question. You said what? I have an idea. But remember, ladies and gentlemen, don't go away, as we will be having a sit-down interview conversation between both David and Dobby before their matchup at Final Destination. Lexi with a huge win over Moon, showing how much of a dominant champion that she is. But Luna already knows what she wants, and this will be the fight of the night. Luna and Lexi for the Turmoil Women's Championship. A rivalry rekindled in old flames, as Dobby has told us. All right, you guys, ladies and gentlemen, that was Monday Night Turmoil. But do not go away, as I said, as we are now getting ready to have our sit-down conversation here with both best friends, bitter rivals, fighting for the ICW Global Worldwide Championship. Oh, wait a minute. A fight has broken out backstage. Hold on, wait a second.
Oh, shit. No, I mean.
Hey, security, what I'm paying you for? Security, somebody help! Oh my goodness. Guys, get us a medic. Get us a medic now. What you gotta say to yourself, bro?
You said in an interview, you ain't tell me I had to fight nobody.
You just like laid that out your own homie.
And your homie came at me. Alright? He my best friend. Pause. Nah. Cause this was like, y'all come at a champion. And now in a global worldwide champion, and he came at me. I don't. I bust my ass for this company. I don't want to hear it.
You know what? You're right. So just know one thing. The Joker will have his revenge.
And the punch.
Y'all cutting out? Alright, hold on, my fault. Just know. The Joker will have his revenge.
And Dobby gets his last laugh at the butt of the joke. Watch.
Alright. So I hope you two will have fun. Because you guys' match will be inside. Hell. In a cell. This is over.